unto Judea, into the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David.
To be taxed with Mary, his espoused wife, being a great little child. And so it was that while they were there, days were accomplished that she should be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, and wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for that in the baby.
And there were in the same country shepherds abiding in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And lo, the angel of the Lord came upon them, and they were sore afraid. And the angel said unto them, Fear not, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people.
For unto you is born this day in the city of David the Savior, which is Christ the Lord. And this shall be a sign unto you, and you'll find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, praising God and saying,
Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men.
And it came to pass, as the angels were gone away from them into heaven, the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go even unto Bethlehem, and see this thing which is come to pass, which the Lord hath made known unto us. And they came with haste, and found Mary, Joseph, and the babe lying in the manger. And when they had seen it, they made known abroad the saying which was told them concerning this child.
And all they that heard it wondered at these things which were told by the shepherds. But Mary kept all these things, and pondered them in her heart, and the shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all things that they had heard and seen as it was told unto them.
Shall be with child, and shall bring forth a son, and they shall call his name Emmanuel, which being interpreted is God with us.
That mourns in lonely exile.
inform thee, O Israel, fear not, for I have redeemed thee. I have called thee by thy name, thou art mine. When thou passest through the waters, I will be with thee, and through the rivers, they shall not overflow thee. When thou walkest through the fire, thou shalt not be burned, neither shall the flame kindle upon thee.